So let's have the bottom of the deck for the overall energy at this time. And I say March, but you know how time is fluid, and I always count on you for your best decisions, your best judgment. Queen of Swords, Gemini, Libra, or Aquarius, you might be dealing with an air sign, and boy, you are a little bit stressed about Nine of Swords. And here you show up with the Hermit. You are stressed. Maybe a connection went cold if it's not an air sign. For some of you not dealing with an air sign, Gemini, Libra, or Aquarius, somebody went cold, distant, silent, not sharing what's going on. And the Nine of Swords is all about now we're worried, right? Now we are worried. It's not in their way of doing things. So past energies. We do have the Nine of Pentacles. We do have the Three of Cups. Wheel of Fortune and the Strength, Leo energy. Four of Swords. Ten of Cups. Two of Wands. Some of you might have been married to this person. We do have marriage energies and the Magician. Might have been a while. I kind of feel that I'm picking up the energy of a Virgo who was in a connection with someone and had a family, Ten of Cups, and then changes came. And there was a divine timing on it, and there was a divine change on it. Nine of Pentacles. We've been single probably ever since. And it has a sense of peacefulness, and it has a sense of acceptance in the past energies. It has a sense of strength and new beginnings. So I feel that it's been a while. They are almost gone from your energy, Virgo, this person of yours. And it feels like you are comfortably single, or that's what you have from the past, right? Coming to terms and making peace with the situation. Finally, being able, to celebrate single life and peacefulness and a quiet moment with yourself. But that was a choice. There was a change in path for you in the past. And with the Magician, I kind of feel you took control and you started already. It's been a while, right? That you feel confident that your life is on the right path. Strong, courageous, right? And I feel that you made peace in the past. So I don't see you tormented like this, but we do have the Nine of Swords, the overall energy, right? Something concerns you. So you are not dragging from the past any baggage, if you ask me. So let's see what's going on right now. We do have the Judgment. We do have the High Priestess. Page of Pentacles. And the Three of Swords. The Emperor, Aries energy. Two of Wands again, I know. The World, that is an ending. And the Hermit again. I see what's going on, right? It's a cycle coming back again. I don't feel it's the same person, though. I feel that we were in such a comfortable place in the past, right? And we had our struggles, but then we made peace and we saw the beauty in the changes that came. And they came with a sense of you being strong and being good by yourself, and manifesting what you want and making magic happen in your life. But I feel right now we are actually going through an ending, Two of Wands and the World. Something just ended recently. We are still in the Nine of Swords energy, right? I'm stressed. I don't know. Connection went cold. I need to make a decision. I need to take control. We have your intuition telling you, right? We need to choose a path. This is hurting, whatever you're having right now. So maybe I'm picking up the energy of somebody who, of a Virgo who really met someone. And I feel that you see the ending coming. I'm not sure you are already in that ending, at least the energy I'm picking up, but you feel it coming, and you need to make a decision. And the beauty of it is that you have the hermit, which is your energy as the overall, and you have it right now. So kind of like you went through this, you know this, you can handle this. You know the light that you need to shine on this, the level of control. High Priestess, your intuition is on point. You feel that this is, you know, a decision is coming, and you feel that, we need a new cycle. I mean, Three of Swords and the Hermit, whatever is going on right now is really hurtful. It has also the energy of silence. Virgo, I don't know if somebody is giving you the silent treatment. Honestly, it does feel like that silence might be hurtful, but your intuition is guiding you perfectly at this point. And we have you with a page of Pentacles and the World. So I don't know if you right now are, you know, about to finish something, or you just received the message, the information that this is going to be over, or this is leading nowhere. And but it has a lot of strength. Your energy, because we ask for your energy, right? It has the inner strength and the light and the wisdom and the control to manage this just as fine. So let's have the possible outcome moving forward. We do have the Moon, Pisces energy, Three of Swords, Ace of Pentacles, the Empress, Taurus Libra energy, King of Cups, Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio, the Death, Scorpio energy, Seven of Wands, and the Six of Swords. So Virgo, this is all in the World, bottom of the deck. So it is over, and it comes with new beginnings, and it comes with overcoming emotions. I feel that we need some peace of mind. We need, Virgo, this is by excellence the Empress and the Six of Swords is remember who you are and move away from tormented waters. You know, let the abundance and creativity and good energies come to you. I kind of feel we need to let go of something. We might be, you know, overwhelmed, or the energy coming your way, it's a lot of dealing with the emotions of a separation. And it comes with reinforcement. That's the Empress, right? You have everything you need. You have it in you. Six of Swords, some peace of mind would be good in March. Seven of Wands, right? Protect yourself, your bubble, your world, and fight for a new beginning and allow this new beginning, right? Because the emotions are, for some of you, not listening to your intuition, because it might be we worry too much. So, you know, the voice inside of you, that is a voice inside of you saying, this connection is hurtful. Twice the Three of Swords is a lot of pain, right? This connection is hurtful. The Moon is hidden, is maybe forbidden, is prohibited, is it's not in the day of, it's not under the sun, right? Not for everybody to see. That is something that is just not right, right? And we do have the Emperor and the Empress. You might have married this person, you might be out of a marriage, but I kind of feel March is about allowing new beginnings, and especially shining a light on overwhelming emotions and putting a stop to the hurt that they are, the heartbreak that they are creating in your life, you know, for some of you. And the World, happy endings, right? We can transform an ending into an opportunity. So let's ask for some guidance. You do have Leo energy. What else? You have Aries energy, Taurus, Virgo, like yourself, Capricorn, Scorpio, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. You have honestly all the signs. So what do we have, Virgo? Sexual freedom. I feel that you are guided to separate from this person who is still in your energy, still messing up your whole day. Rainbow Reviver. We forgot to have some fun. Amuse ourselves and inner peace. I'm not surprised. Inner peace. We have the Nine of Swords as the overall. So this is all about the practices we can put in place to achieve some happiness in everyday life. And we have the compatibility. kind of a confirmation that there was an issue there, right? And yes, you are stressed, but there is no solution to that. It's really not being compatible. Express your love through gifts. A small token of love can convey great appreciation. So how about you gift yourself the inner peace you need? And this is the energy that really wanted to come out, and it is elevation. So you are making the conscious decision to raise your vibration of love. Ah, Virgo. I kind of feel that they kept us stuck in a rut. Virgo, twice the Three of Swords, the Death, the World a couple of times. You know, it was over and yet we were hoping something. We remained attached to someone who went cold on us. Disconnected, maybe blocked us in some way, and the whole universe is saying we need to raise our vibration, we need to forget about the frequency we were connected to, and you know, move a step up, kind of, or take a step up. Elevation. Then we have release failure. I understand that a mistake is only an opportunity to learn. All that to say, this connection was an experience. Purpose. I know what I'm here to do. And going back to the High Priestess, you know it. You know it. Right? This is just not right. Surrender. I can release my need to control. And maybe you're trying to fix the connection, compatibility, and the need to control, you know, hoping that eventually if we change, we can, you know, blend better. But it's not about that, right? Surrender to creativity. You do have the Empress also, the whole reading. So let your imagination soar. Stay open to all creative ideas about how to pursue a dream and solve a problem. Yeah, I know, right? It takes a lot of creativity. Because they kept you stuck in a rut. That is no doubt. That is no doubt. So hey. Shine a light, Virgo. Shine a light. You have the Hermit twice. This is your energy. You are powerful. You are strong. If only you were able to see it, right? That's a Hermit. Shining a light on a hidden situation. And the Moon. You also have the Moon, right? We need to kind of take the lid off of a situation and see it through the lenses of the person you are today. So, guys, this is all that I have for you. You know I love you. I wish you nothing but the best. I want you to stay strong and safe. And come see me next time. Love you. Take care.